he indeed. To all my tearful prayers he answers me, a shepherd lad is no fit helpmate for a ward in chancery. I stood in court, and there I sang him songs of Arcady, with flageolet accompaniment, in vain. At first he seemed amused, and so did the bar, but quickly wearying of my summoned pipe, bade me get out. A servile usher then, in crumpled bands and rusty bombazine, led me still singing into chancery lane. I'll go no more, I'll marry her today, and brave the upshot, be it what it may. But who are these?
Oh, Strephon, rejoice with me, for my queen has pardoned me.
Pardoned you, mother, this is good news indeed.
And these ladies are my beloved sisters.
Your sisters? Then they are my aunts.
A pleasant piece of news for your bride on her wedding day.
Hush, my bride knows nothing of my fairyhood. I dare not tell her, lest it frighten her. Well, she thinks me mortal and prefers me so.
Your fairyhood doesn't seem to have done you much good.
Much good, my dear aunt. It's the curse of my existence. What's the use of being half a fairy? My body can creep through a keyhole, but that's of no use, for my legs are left kicking behind. I can make myself invisible down to the waist. But what's the good in that when my legs remain exposed to view? My brain is a fairy brain, but from the waist downwards I'm a gibbering idiot. My upper half is immortal, but my lower half grows older every day, and some they are that must die of old age. Well, what's to become of my upper half when I've buried my lower half? I really don't know.
Oh, fellow, I see your difficulty. But with a fairy brain, you should seek an intellectual sphere of action.
Now, let me see.
I've a borough at my disposal. Would you like to go into Parliament?
A fairy member? Oh, that would be delightful.
Well, I'm afraid I should do no good there. Well, you see, down to the waist, I'm a Tory of the most determined description. But my legs were a couple of confounded radicals, and on a division, they'd be sure to take me to the wrong lobby. You see, they're 2-1, which is a strong working majority.
Don't let that distress you. You shall be returned as a radical conservative, and your legs shall be our peculiar care.
I see your majesty does not do things by halves.
No, we are fairies down to the feet.
Danger, peril, or perplexity.
2 years. Don't you think you could wait 2 years?
2 years? Have you ever looked in the glass?
No, never.
Here, take a look at that and tell me if you think it rational to expect me to wait 2 years.
No! You're quite right.
It's asking too much. One must be reasonable.
Besides, who knows what may happen in 2 years? Well, you may fall in love with the Lord Chancellor himself by that time.
Yes, he's a clean old gentleman.
As it is, half the House of Lords are sighing at your feet.
The House of Lords are certainly extremely attentive.
Attentive? I should think they were. Why did 25 radical peers come down to shoot over your grass plot last autumn? Don't tell me it was the sparrows. And why did 25 Conservative peers come down to fish your pond? It couldn't have been the goldfish. No, no. Delays are dangerous, and if we're to marry, the sooner the better.